your slipper.
Oh, merci, mademoiselle.
I'm going to go for a swim. Bye.
Merci.
Jesus, I thought you were drowning. I was wondering when I was going to have to haul you out or not.
Hey, Miranda.
You were here before, weren't you?
4 years ago. Your brother was here, not you.
Well, I don't really live here. But we come every year for Mummy's birthday to console her. Christopher's so distracted he couldn't quite find his way out of the turkey.
It's Niccolo.
Do you know Niccolo?
From last time.
You don't smoke by any miracle, do you?
Not really.
Richard freaks out when I smoke.
When are they coming back?
Who?
Your brother.
Who knows? They said... Richard!
Hi, Beth.
Oh, and this is, you know, Harmon's... Mummy's friend's daughter, Lucy. Lucy.
Oh, my God. You're Sarah Harmon's daughter. Your mother was a great poet. Irma, Richard Reed, really, really honored to meet you.
It's my mother, not me.
Yeah, but she made me want to be a poet. I mean, I think it would be great, you know, just to sit around all day and express yourself.
Richard, I never knew you wrote poetry.
Well, honey, I never did. I don't have a creative bone in my body. I did become an entertainment lawyer, so that I could be around creative people, like Miranda.
I design jewelry. I apprenticed to this real asshole in New York, but he's a genius.
Okay.
Yes, but that was old shit. He's going in.
How is it in there, Lucy?
Quiet as a tomb.
What? No, I'm losing your voice. You sound like you're at the bottom of the sea.
You have to speak up.
Listen to this. Cara Noemi, ci sono due uomini nella mia vita. Uno è capace di appagarmi come non credevo fosse possibile, ma si comporta come se io non esistessi.
L'altro è affettuoso con me, ma niente sesso. Dimostra il suo amore per me. Davanti alla finestra. Sono lacerata tra i due. Cosa devo fare? L'indecisa.
Bella, eh?
Who's on the phone? Miranda. Who's on the phone?
Christopher. What did he say?
They're not coming back.
What, never?
Well, I don't know. They missed a connection or something I couldn't hear.
Those naughty boys. I bet they're being very naughty.
I'm sure they've gone beyond naughty by now.
Noemi writes for the Lonely Hearts column called Ditelo a Noemi, Tell Noemi. That's quite a following. Here she is.
I have a picture of Mom in this dress.
She said, After she got married, she was going to be fat and happy and had no more use for it. Of course, she never gained any pounds. Sit down. You could wear it to the Donati's party. They give a lovely one every summer. You could be Sarah, 20 years ago, coming to help us fix up this place.
She helped you fix this place up?
Well, with a lot of hash breaks.
I think it's a little long. Why don't you get up here? Go and pin it. Your mother needed to risk things. I admire the recklessness in her. It was so not me. I could be brave. I couldn't live where she lived. Neither is Ian. Do you know, I think we've been faithful to each other for 20 years. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
Most people can't.
Suddenly want Lucy to come here.
Maybe it was Lucy who wanted to come. Now she's here, stranded with us old fogies.
Well, speak for yourself.
I'm sure she'd rather be out chasing boys around on the beach somewhere.
It seemed rather serious to me.
With being chased. 19 is all about boys. You know, I caught her looking at a picture of Christopher.
Christopher.
Why not? She's 19.
You're not sleepy?
No, not at all. I have to finish Daisy's dress. I must switch off all the lights. I'll try not to wake you up when I get in.
Come here. Good night, kiss. Bye-bye. You were 19 once, I suppose, weren't you?
I suppose I must have been.
Excuse me, but you wouldn't happen to have any more of that exotic brand of cigarette I can sell, would you?
Hi.
My best play.
I really liked it.
But it's the one they'll remember me for. I'm not contagious, you know.
I always